Hey, welcome back to our live show. You can take this if you want.
I was just so excited. This is such an exciting topic to cover.
Okay, all right. Well, the Peter Paul Development Center is a great local resource in the River City that serves Richmond's East End through its mission to educate the child, engage the family, and empower the community.
Damon Jiggetts, the executive director of the program, is here along with director of education, Dr. Stephanie Bassett, to talk about the value of summer learning. It's great to have both of you with us.
Thanks for having us.
Glad to be here.
This is a super important time. You have a program that's already in progress. It's about an 8-week project. But why is summer such an important time for families and children to try to target?
We'll go with that.
I will. The National Center for After School and Summer Enrichment indicates that summertime is a time for great inequity among young people. Many young people and their families tend to lose critical supports to healthy lifestyles, safety, and opportunities for learning.
Debbie, tell us about the impact that learning throughout the year, and not just that maybe late August through May. Why is it so important to engage the child?
Well, you know, the longer you have a child in our care or any educational program's care, we're ensuring that there isn't any learning being lost over the course of the summer. And so at Peter Paul, we want to make sure that we serve our children and their families as long as we can throughout the course of the school year. And retaining those students from year to year is even more important.
While you're also having fun, too.
Right, yes, right. Yes. There are a lot of enrichment activities that go on and support the educational endeavors of our children, and our teachers who are well prepared and well qualified to serve our kids are doing a wonderful job. So like I was telling you a little earlier, it's organized chaos over there in the building right now. We've got about 190 of the students in there with us.
Now, Stephanie, you mentioned, you know, not having access to certain resources. And at a more base level, you get off your routine. Folks who may be having meals provided at school now don't have those. So this is a critical situation for young people and for families. So this really is picking up the gap. Summer Promise offers a lot.
Summer Promise does offer a lot, and we do pick up the gap by offering both breakfast and lunch to our students while they are attending our program. But in addition to that, providing those enrichment opportunities through our strategic community partnerships, we provide our students with opportunities for golf, opportunities for swimming, even opportunities to experience digital photography, in addition to the critical component of academic instruction. So we do provide 3 hours of academic instruction on a daily basis for our students. And that does help to, again, prevent that summer learning loss.
Stephanie and Damon, Peter Paul Development isn't just impacting young people as well. I mean, this is really goes beyond the walls of just your facility. This impacts not only underprivileged, young, but also seniors in the community as well,
right,
and families. Really, when it comes down to it.
Right. Well, you mentioned it earlier. You said it's to educate the child, engage the family, and empower the community. So it's really a comprehensive organization up on
Indeed.
Church Hill, which is characterized as some of the densest concentration of poverty. But we don't want people to believe that, you know, our children and our families are at risk. We see that community and the families and the residents there as being full of potential, including our senior citizens. And so we want to make sure that they have somewhere that they can go, where they can engage in activities and socialize and doing those things as well. And so we partner with so many organizations and housing initiatives, employment initiatives, and of course educational initiatives that play out in the East End.
And we hear so much about the work that you're doing in the community, and you have so many fantastic community partners, but you said it's organized chaos right now,
right,
and pretty much the whole year through as you're
right,
serving so many folks. You need support. You
right,
need volunteers.
Right, right. So we have a wonderful volunteer coordinator, our director of volunteer services, I should say, managing close to 1,000 volunteers who come through our doors throughout the course of the year, serving as mentors, tutors, helping out in the gardens, administrative support. We have our parents, which again is very important to us, making sure that we're affording opportunities for parents to be engaged. They come out and help us out with events, putting cake on the plates for birthday parties in the classrooms, you name it. It's really a changing, flipping the dime on its head and saying, it's not so much what can we do for you, but what can you do for yourselves, for your children, and your community.
The programs that the young people are involved with now, Doctor, when they get back into the classroom, how far long ahead are they? They're getting a jump on education because they're not starting from negative. They're almost in the positive, really.
They're in the positive. Our teachers, we have a close partnership with Richmond Public Schools. So throughout the year, we're gaining student data, both academic data, attendance data, and behavioral data. So with that information that we receive, our teachers know exactly where they should focus, where they can provide that enrichment, where they can provide remediation, and it's giving our students, as you indicated, a jump start in their education for when they return to school.
It's going to be so gratifying.
Yes.
Very much
yes.
so.
Thanks for the work that you're doing. Appreciate
no problem
it.
At all.
We're going to share some information. For information on the Peter Paul Development Center, we'll have a link on our website by early this afternoon at WTVR.com/VTM.